Hello students, welcome back to the science class. We were discussing about the topic getting to know plants. In this topic, we have discussed about the structure and function of leaf, venation, types of venation. Later, we discussed about the root, types of roots, that is taproot and fibrous root, and the function of root, right? Today, we are discuss about flowers, the most colorful and attractive part of the plant, that is flower. Structure and functions of the flower. The most attractive and colorful part of the plant is flower. The colorful part of the flower is called as petal. You can see here, variety of flowers have different colors on them. These petals, colorful part of the flower, are called as petals. Different flowers have different colors. Petals are protected by a small leaf-like structure called sepals. You can see here, sepals. It helps to protect the bud. Okay, these are called as sepals, and the colorful part of the flower is called as petal. Petals are most attractive part of the plant. These are the external structure of the flower. You can see stigma, style, ovary and ovule, all these are the female part of the flower, whereas anther and filament are called as the male part, that is stamen. Stigma, style, ovary and ovule are the pistil part, means female part of the flower. Let us discuss about male and female part in detail. Stigma to ovary. Stigma, style, ovule and ovary, all these part together called as pistil. Pistil means female part. Okay. Whereas anther and filament. Anther and filament are called as stamen. Stamen means male part of the flower. Male reproductive organ consists of two parts, filament and anther. Filament and anther is called as male reproductive part. A long thin tube like structure is called as filament. It is a long tube like structure, right? It is called as filament. Anther, a knob like structure attached to the top of the filament. Anther produces pollen, male gamete. You can see here, a knob-like structure which is attached to the filament is called as anther. It produces a small structure. You can see it is a very velvety powder-like structure. That is called as pollen, pollen grains. These are called as male gamete. Okay? Anther and filament are the male reproductive part of a flower. Male reproductive part produces a yellow color powdery substance called as pollen or pollen grains. This is about the male reproductive part of a flower. Let's see about female reproductive part, that is pistil. Pistil consists of four different parts. First one is stigma, style, ovary and ovule. Okay, stigma is the uppermost sticky platform at the top of the style where pollen is deposited. Okay, this is stigma, is the it is flat in nature. It has a style continually connected with the style. Style is a tube-like structure. Stigma helps to deposit the pollen grains, which is produced by the male gamete. That yellow color powder-like structure falls on the stigma. It has a hole and which is connected with the style. Style is a long, slender stalk that connects to the stigma and the ovary. It connects to the stigma as well as ovary. Stigma is the upper part of the female organ, whereas ovary is the last part in which ovules are produced. Stigma collects the pollen grain in it and it sends to the style, whereas style passes the pollen grains to the ovary. What is ovary then? Ovary is the enlarged basal portion of the pistil where ovules are produced. Ovary is the last part of the female reproductive organ of a flower in which ovules are produced. Ovules are called as female gametes. When the male gamete, that is pollen grain, falls on the stigma, it sends to the style. Style passes the pollen grains to the ovary, whereas ovary reproduces the ovule and sends the male part, that is pollen grains, to the ovule. When ovule and ovary fuses, it forms a gamete. Okay, this ovary converts into a fruit, whereas ovules converts as a seed. This procedure is called as fertilization. About this in detail you are going to learn in 7th standard. Just we have to remember the male and female part of the flower. Stigma, style, ovary and ovule are called as female reproductive part of a flower, whereas filament and anther are the parts of the stamen, which is called as male reproductive part of a flower. Let us describe once again the structure of flower by using the points to recall the structure of flower. The innermost part of a flower is called the pistil. Pistil means female part, which is deeper inside the flower and covered with the colorful petals on it. Flowers are important in making seeds. These are the functions of flowers. Flowers are most important in making seeds. Flowers can be made up of different parts, but there are some parts that are basic equipment. The main flower part are the male part called as the stamen and the female part called the pistil. Pistil and stamen are the two important internal parts of a flower which plays a vital role in fertilization. If there is no reproduction of the plant of the flower, then there will be no new plants will grow. There is no formation of fruit and seed in the plant. Okay, so reproduction plays a vital role, which is the responsible for the continuation of that species. The stamen has two parts, one is anther and another one is filament. The anther carries the pollen grain. These are generally yellow in color. Anthers are held up by the thread-like part called filament. Filament is a tube-like structure which carries the anther. Anther is a yellow color powdery substance which carries pollen grains. This is called as male reproductive part of a flower. The pistil has three parts: stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is the sticky surface at the top of the pistil. It traps and holds the pollen grain. It is little sticky, little gummy in nature. When the anther falls, pollen grain falls on the stigma, it traps, it holds on its surface because it is very sticky. Later, it sends inside the tube-like structure called as style. The style is the tube-like structure that holds up the stigma. The style leads down to the ovary that contains the ovules. Style is the center part of a pistil which ends with the stigma at the top, and it contains pollen grains and it carries to the ovary. Ovary contains ovules. Other parts of the flower that are important are called as petals and sepals. Petals are attracted pollinator and are usually the reason why we buy and enjoy flowers. Flowers are very attractive. They are very attract in so that they can attract the pollinators, which is the most important reason for the fertilization. And even we also buy variety of colorful flower to decorate our homes, to give somebody as a gift, and we enjoy with the flowers, right? The sepals are the green petal-like parts at the base of the flower. Sepals help protect the developing bud. Sepals protect the bud from very cold or harsh winter or from wind to protect the bud. It act as a protector for the development of bud. Flowers can have either all male parts or female parts or combination of flowers. With all male parts or female parts are called as imperfect. Example of imperfect, there are two types of flower. One is imperfect and another one is perfect flower. Even at the higher level, we can call them as bisexual flower or unisexual flower. That is of next level. Here we are going to consider flower of two type. Imperfect means they have either male part or female part. Such flowers are called as imperfect flowers. Example, cucumbers, pumpkin and melons. Whereas some flowers have both male and female part. They are called as perfect flowers. Example for this is rose, lilies, dandelion. Even just we studied about the structure of hibiscus. All these are the examples of perfect flowers. You can see here, anther and filament is called as male part of the flower, whereas stigma, style, ovary, these dot-like structures are called as ovules. Once this anther, because of wind or by animal, it falls on the stigma, it is very sticky. So, once it falls on the stigma, it allows that anther, that pollen grains, it sends to the style. Style is a tube-like structure, it passes that anther to the ovary. Okay, then fertilization takes place. That ovary develops and it grows in larger size. Ovary forms a fruit, whereas these ovules become seed of that fruit. This method is called as fertilization. Let us see, stamens are the male reproductive part of a flower. Each stamen has two parts, a thin stalk called filament and a knob-like structure called anther. The anther produces a powdery substance called pollen. Anther produces a powdery substance called as pollen grains. Whereas carpel is the under name of pistil, is also known as female reproductive part of a flower. It is the female reproductive part of the flower. It has three parts, a sticky top portion called stigma, an enlarged base called as ovary. This is the sticky part called as stigma, enlarged base called as ovary, and a stalk called as style that connects ovary and stigma. This style connects stigma to ovary. Okay, the ovary contains tiny ball-like structure called ovules. You can see here, this is the ovary which is in oval shape and it contains ball-like small structure called as ovules, which later become seeds. After fertilization, it becomes seed and this ovary become a fruit and remaining parts will dry and fall off. Petals are colorful structure that surround the inner part of the flower. Why these petals are colorful means they attract the pollinators. Okay. Then coming to the sepal. Sepal are the green leaf-like structure at the base of the flower. You can see here sepals. In our first diagram we have seen, right? That is called as sepal. Sepals protect the flower during its development and support the petal when the flower blooms. If there are no sepals, the bud become destroyed. So the function of the sepal is to protect the bud till it blooms as a flower. Sepal and petal are the external organs of the flower which protects the reproductive part of a flower. This is about Hope you understood the concept. If you have any doubt, we can discuss in our live class. Once again, read the topic. Thank you. Bye bye.